Hello guys, here's another update. I uploaded a video there last night, just different things I'm doing to the CR500 hot saw. So I finally got the head cut down to the right diameter. Let me grab the old head and I'll show you. So I just started working on the cutting the expansion chamber. Okay. Or combustion chamber, not expansion chamber. Sorry, combustion chamber and the squish band. So, yeah, I know it still looks bigger, but it's not. It is the right diameter. Okay, so that's what I've been working on. Finally, I brought it from 8 inches down to like 5 1/4, I think it is. So quite a bit of metal I cut through, if you watched the last video. Other than that, I got the engine torn down now. So this was an air-cooled 84 model, first year for the CR500. Somebody had cut the fins off, but they did a terrible job. You cut in on angles and whatever you got to do with a zip disc to get them off and break them off, but no one sanded them down after. So I spent some time grinding them down. You know, they look a lot better now. Yeah, and this is going to be painted. This and this will be assembled together, top and bottom end, and then we'll paint it. Okay, I did buy black paint with primer. I'm going to switch. I think I'm going to paint it red because my buddy Will, he's got a CR500 hot saw too, and his is red and it looks really sweet. So I'm going to do that red. I got to sand down in there where it's painted red. I gotta redo that, and then any bare aluminum I'm gonna be buffing it and polishing it up a bit. Not crazy, not to a mirror finish or anything, but so yeah. So this tear down, so this saw was all running and I had it running good and everything, so this is the final tear down. Make the new head, put this all together, install it, install the cylinder piston. Leave the head off, just mask everything off. I'm going to paint the top and bottom end red, and then the head's going to be like just the polished aluminum, bare aluminum. It'll look good, and then those little red accents in there will be redone red. Right now I am working on the pipe, so I got the wire brush out for any rust spots like this, and then I got some different kind of buffers, and then once I get that broken off of it, then I will, you'll never bring it back to perfect, but I'll be able to clean it up pretty good. The main thing is the outside part that you see, like here, FMF gnarly, is in pretty good shape. So then I'll bring it to a polish as best as I can. So yeah, after that's done, then I'm going to clean these two, assemble them, mask it off, prime it, paint it today. And when it's drying, I'm going to finish the head in the lathe. So hopefully by tomorrow I can assemble it all. Tomorrow or the next day. Yeah, probably be the next day. Maybe Sunday. Something like that. It is, Thursday today. Tomorrow's a PD day, so I'll have my son here. So maybe I can put him to work doing something. Okay, guys. Thanks for tuning in. I just wanted to give you an update. Okay. So I got the... It's about... from the first clip that you just watched, it's about probably 3 hours later, if I had to guess. Three and a half. Anyway, there's the pipe. Remember how rusted it was? Even up at the header, came out pretty good. See? If you look in between the spring loops and where I couldn't get, that's what it used to look like from that to that. So. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with how it came out. Anyway, yeah, that'll look good. And we're gonna paint this red. That's not paint, that's just a mark. I had to redo the threads in that hole, so that's done. These are all degreased clean. So, another thing. So everything, all the body parts are now done, like sanding and polishing. I didn't really polish anything, but I mean, everything's used to have red inside the Honda, and it used to have red inside all these machined out grooves. But it didn't have any primer and it wasn't sanded, so it didn't stick. Even just the hose or the power washer took it off. But anyway, I sanded all this down. Like, there was people screwed some holes in this, previous owners. You know, I sanded them down a bit. So like I said, all the body work, all the parts of the body of the saw, the clutch cover, well, there's no clutch, but chain cover and whatnot, it's all done. The blocks are done. The lower handle, operator, throttle handle, it's all done. Top ends smoothed out. These were super jagged before, and I ground for hours to get them smoothed out so it looks presentable. But I'm happy with that. Took off quite a bit of weight too. Bottom end's done. It's just draining. I cleaned it out. There's the connecting rod at the top of it. So yeah, so and then so that's all done. Everything's done over there, ready for assembly. Well, ready for paint and then assembly. Now it's for the head. This is what I just stopped working on before I picked up this phone. So there's the head coming along. You can see I got my squish band in, and I'm starting to get my combustion chamber cut to where I need it to be. Here's the old head, side by side. So you can see I went with a wider squish band. It's not quite opened up as much as it needs to be yet. I got a few more passes, but you know, a week ago this was yay tall. It was just barely touching, or just barely cleared my bed. So, you know, yay about that, yay tall. So once I finish cutting this combustion chamber, then I will flip this around in the chuck, and I will grab with my teeth, I'll grab right here, forcing outward, and then I can, you know, machine the outer dimensions. So yeah, that's that, working on the head. So tomorrow, that's it for tonight. So for tomorrow, first thing I'm gonna do is give this another cleaning with brake clean, wipe everything down, put the piston on the bottom end, put the top end on, bolt everything down, mask everything off that needs to be masked. I'll use the old head. I'll put the old head on it just to cover it for painting. And then I'm gonna prime it, paint it. And then I'm leaving the new head just pure aluminum. I'll polish it up so it's gonna look good. But the cylinder and the base, the bottom end will be red. I was gonna go black and I bought black paint. That's why it's not painted today. But then I seen a buddy of mine's hot saws. He does his red and they look real good. So, especially with a nice chrome pipe. Anyway, yeah, that's it guys. So stay tuned, a couple more days, we'll have her together. This is just one more update video for you. Have a good night, cheers.